The last thing we need to do is figure out how to use the Smith chart to determine the VSWR value and where the voltage maxima and minima occur on the transmission line. Both of these can be found along the circle of constant reflection coefficient magnitude, which is this dotted orange line going around the center of the Smith chart. First, the VSWR can be read off the Smith chart, where the circle, the orange dotted circle, crosses the horizontal axis to the right of the origin. So right here, we can read off the VSWR value directly at this point. This location also corresponds to where all the voltage maxima occur. So, you know, remember as you spin around further and further away from the load, say for example, you're going to cross this multiple times. So each time you cross this axis, you're going to be crossing a point where there's a voltage maximum. Then the voltage minima occur where the circle of constant reflection coefficient magnitude, this orange dotted circle, crosses the horizontal axis to the left of the origin, so right here. And that's where the incident and reflected voltage phasor are 180 degrees at a phase, anti-parallel. Let's continue our example from earlier. And with the following additional information, so let's say RG is equal to 25 ohms. First, what is closest to the load, a voltage maximum or a voltage minimum?